In this example, we're going to try to find the area under the curve from 1 to 4 of the square root of 7 over x. Now, something that's common to a lot of integral problems, whether it's definite integrals like this from 1 to 4, or even the indefinite integrals where you write the antiderivative with a plus c, either way, because our integration rules are so limited, we only have a couple, we only have a handful. Primarily, the way you're going to integrate these is by rewriting these integrands in an acceptable way that fit one of our handful of rules. So we have to be a lot more clever than we were when we took derivatives, because we don't have versions of the product rule and quotient rule for integration. So we just have to be more clever in how we rewrite things before we actually do the integral. So I would say a good 75% of this problem is realizing how to rewrite this in an acceptable format. So first thing I see is I've got a quotient and I've got composition, and I don't really have a good, you know, idea of what to do as far as the quotient rule for integration, because there's not one. So the first thing I think I would do is break this apart into the square root of 7 divided by, so integral 1 to 4, of the square root of 7 divided by the square root of x. And then having the square root of x in the denominator, I think I know how to handle that as well. I can bring that up to the numerator, and there won't be division at all anymore if you write it as the square root of 7 times x to the negative 1/2. A 1/2 power is the same thing as a square root operation, and bringing it up from the numerator means that we would make the exponent negative. Now, why would I prefer to write it this way instead of in the last two formats? Well, this fits the handful of rules that I have. The square root of 7 is a tag-along constant. It's a constant multiple of the function. So I can pull that outside the integral because it's a constant. And x to the minus 1/2 is simply a power. And so I do have a power rule for integration, unlike a product rule or quotient rule, which I did not have. So here we go. I'm going to take this guy's antiderivative, the square root of 7. It'll just kind of hang around for a little bit. For the x to the minus 1/2, I would add 1 to the exponent instead of subtract 1 like you would for a derivative. So we get x to the positive 1/2 divided by 1/2 with a bracket and a 1 and a 4. Now, we don't typically like to write it this way when you have something divided by another fraction. So something better you could do is actually take the reciprocal of this fraction, and then you won't have a fraction within a larger fraction. So here we go. We'll bring this 2 up. 2 square root of 7 x to the 1/2 power, bracket with a 1 and a 4. So we will plug in a 4. And we'll plug in a 1, and we'll subtract these two quantities. So let's do that. If you plug in a 4, square root of 4 is 2. 2 times 2 is 4 root 7. So if you plug in a 4, you get 4 root 7. If you plug in a 1, the square root of 1 is 1. 1 times 2 root 7 is 2 root 7. 4 root 7 minus 2 root 7 would be 2 root 7. So this will be our final answer. Now, what does that answer represent? Well, the same as every other definite integral, this is the area under this curve from 1 to 4, right? So the thing I wanted to illustrate primarily in this example here, the thing I want to get across to you, is the importance of looking at an integrand and rewriting it some way using algebra so that it fits one of the small handful of integration rules that we do have.